Our final and last speaker is a successful social media and public relations strategist, entrepreneur, speaker based in Singapore. He's also the best-selling author of a series of popular books, such as, for example, Social Media 24/7, Public Relations 24/7, and Personal Branding 24/7. He has spoken in over 15 over countries within these 5 years and addressed more than 35,000 people. May we put hands together to welcome Mr. Andrew Chow.
Hello. Okay, so after hearing the entire morning about a lot of brands from a lot of amazing speakers, I think I'd like to address, a certain topic that is very close to everybody's heart. Now, what about personal branding? Now, before I start the topic, I want to share to you a story about digital transformation. The story of my 74-year-old mother. I took many years to convince her to be on Facebook. Finally, she's on Facebook. She started updating me on who my cousin is dating in Canada. And in the last 6 months, she asked me, "Son, teach me how to set up a PayPal." I said, "Why do you need a PayPal for?" "Oh, I want to try your e-commerce." I say, "You can't have a PayPal because you don't have credit card." She says, "No problem, use yours first, sir." Digital transformation sometimes will bring us surprises. But most importantly, I think for personal brand, there is a story. There is a story that all of us today in this room have, and I think the world deserves to hear from us. So I just want to share something very quickly about myself. You can check me out on LinkedIn. You can add me, please. I'm available on almost every platform, including Snapchat, One ID. I have written a few books you can also buy from Amazon. I'm not going to promote it today. These are some of the domains that I'm very specialized in, and I love to talk about that. Now, this is a slide I want to spend some time. I'm the person most qualified to talk about disruption. Do you know why? Because I self-disrupted myself a few times in my life. Really, really. The best way to prepare for disruption is to self-disrupt. I mean, self-disrupt. Okay, self-disrupt, it's important. I started my career after my army as an intelligence officer. So actually, I'm quite intelligent. I work for MINDEF. I can't tell you what I do. It's very classified. And after that, I got sick of the civil service life, and I joined Kodak. During those days, Kodak was number one. Who has taken a picture using negative before? Well, you guys have been around for a long time. There was one time I do a talk in NUS. Who has taken a picture of negative? Nobody put up their hand. Everybody is so young, right? It was fantastic. Kodak is a sad story. And it was at Kodak I met my first mentor, Andy. Are you still around, Andy? All right. Andy is someone I met 26 years ago. He's still my mentor. In 1997-98, there's a very, very big event. Anybody remember? The Asia financial crisis, the Tum Yum effect, 20 years ago. And then, of course, I went to join MICE. I went to do a lot of events. And then in 2005, I self-destruct again. I went to become a matchmaker. Yeah, you heard me correctly. I was the only guy doing matchmaking. Mainstream only. Yeah? Okay? So in 2005 to 2009, I met a lot of interesting people. And at 2009, I disrupt again. Why? Social media was on the rise. And I foresaw one day it will eliminate me from all the business. And true enough, today nobody's interested to find a matchmaker. Everybody download Tinder. So Lisa was correct, huh? Everybody wants to connect instantly. I want it now. Who wants to find a matchmaker when there's a technology that can connect me with everyone? And now I'm in the space of training and development, and I love to share stories about how I transform my life. So transformation is the story of my life. Branding. Personal branding. I like to define personal branding in very, very simple words. It's simply your uniqueness made visible with the right form. Now, in the dawn of mankind, cultures brand themselves. We have the Western culture, the Europeans, and the Oriental culture, China, 中国. Two main cultures were trying to brand themselves and they connect. So there was a rise of Renaissance and all these different periods. They are fine. They are fantastic branded culture. Next, in about the turn of this century or the last century, countries go in and brand themselves. They brand themselves by occupying another country, by conquering another country, by declaring war on each other. They brand themselves by seeing who is bigger, who is more powerful. If I'm more powerful, you bow to me, right? Okay? And then, after World War II, companies brand themselves. Companies want to be branded as someone who can create value. And the last speaker has talked a lot about creating value, all right? Connecting with people. And just before the dot-com era, employers join in. We have employer branding. Companies want to use their own brand to attract talent to work for them. Now, what is the final frontier of branding? We have culture, we have country, we have employer, we have companies. Now is the time for individual. Because personal branding is so important, it's already happening. If you are not doing your own personal branding, someone else is doing it for you. Even right now, that branding is called perception. We are supposed to manage perception. Today, I'm just here to share to you 8 simple P's to manage your perception online. You are all heroes of your own story. The world needs to hear from you. You are the differentiator. Whether you're in a B2B or B2C company, it's still people-to-people business. You buy from a person. You connect with a person. You want to hear another person's voice. You want the physical touch, the personal touch. And the only way to be different is you bringing your brand alive. And today, the whole HR world is talking about employee engagement. It's talking about ambassadors in the company. And I'm surprised, in the last 1 year itself, you'll be surprised how many companies send their staff and management to personal branding workshop. So I'm going to share to you a few things. Two things we need to understand about personal brand. One is the form. The form is what everyone can see easily, right? Just now, we exchanged LinkedIn. We can see my favorite pastime is to read people's profile. I'm serious. Whoever I'm supposed to meet, I always check out the LinkedIn. And I make sure I memorize certain key info about the profile, and I use it as an icebreaker. And this person, every time, they'll be very surprised. How do you know? Were you stalking on me? Yeah, of course. I stalked you 5 minutes before I was supposed to meet you. The next thing I want to share to you is this. There is a substance part. Substance of your brand takes some time to discover. It is a substance that determines the form. Substance is a feeling, it's a connection, it's an experience that they have with you. It's the love for you. What is the opposite of love? Hate? No. The opposite of love is indifference. I don't care anymore. I don't care about this person anymore. You don't hate the person, you just don't care. So, our job is to make sure that people that matters to us care about our brand. So I'm going to share to you 8 things you can do to manage your brand. All right? Number one, how to be visible. You've got to take care of your own profile. Please, have you Googled yourself recently? Have you Googled your name recently and find on the first page besides your Facebook and your LinkedIn, what else is being said about you? You'll be very surprised, right? If you Google Andrew Chow in Singapore, there's 2 persons will come out. Okay? One good looking, one not so good looking. So you can find out who is the better looking one. Okay? So you have sites like, have you ever asked yourself, I have so many social media accounts. Can I go to one place and I find all the account of the person? There is a site called About Me. Alright? About Me is very useful. It's still around. Alright, this is my account. Alright, all the icons are behind. All the icons are actually below, so you can see it. But there's another one. That's even better. If you have star phone today, you just have to call Andrew. All right, but please don't call me right now, okay? Please don't call me. So, and I'm very thankful for One Smart Star because anywhere I go in Asia, people can connect with me. They can contact me. They can choose how they want to connect with me. When I was in Malaysia partner, Adrian. When I was in Malaysia speaking, I always share my deck, and the Malaysia partner is so kind to include a link. So whenever they go to my account, they can download the presentation immediately without even having any follow-up action. I don't need them to give me their email. They just download it, all right? Just to show that I'm a brand, that I don't need something from you to give you what you like. So being seen is very important. I want to share with you one thing. How many of you have LinkedIn account? Do you know you all have a score called the Social Selling Index? You go to linkedin.com/sales/SSR, you will see a number. You will see a number, and then you will see four different criteria of that number. You know what that means? Let me tell you. The first column, it's about your profile. How much you key in on your profile determines how many points LinkedIn give it to you. Do you want to know whenever something is being searched, how does LinkedIn decide who comes first and who goes last? It's by the score. Hello? It's by the score. So you've got to increase your score. How to increase the score? Make sure your profile is properly filled up. Make sure you find the right people. If LinkedIn survey your connections and find that a lot of people are actually meaning next to nothing to you, that means you can't serve them, your score will be lower. Third one, engage with insight. Do you share knowledge, content on LinkedIn as often as you do on Facebook? That is important. Today, I'm sure a lot of you learned something new, right? Yes? Yes. So I hope to see some of your posting on LinkedIn. Because when you share with the right hashtag, please hashtag WhatsMaster, hashtag digital transformation, hashtag MIS, hashtag anything that's useful today, somebody will find you. Somebody will connect with you. Last but not least, relationship. When someone sends you a message, do you take 1 year to reply? When someone like your post, do you click on their profile? When someone asks you a question, do you take 3 months to get back to them? All these things helps a lot in your social selling index. So don't take LinkedIn differently. By the way, LinkedIn is not a portal to look for a job. Although it is made that way, now it's for sales. If you sit in my workshop, I will tell you how to find these people. Okay, but not today, okay? Number two, the second P. First was profile. Number two, manage people and info. How many tools do you use here? If my phone is lost, if somehow everything is erased, I can recover back instantly because I back up everything. How a lot of you taking pictures, right? Right now, I can tell you, you will never ever find that picture after 3 months. You want to know why? Because there's no way you can index it. Evernote. I take pictures with Evernote and I continue typing my notes. I just have to tag digital transformation. One Smart Star. I found it. In future, when I call out this name, this note that I'm taking will be out, including all the pictures you have taken today. We use technology, but we don't use it intelligently. Manage people and information. Do you want to save time posting or information on all your social media? Buffer is cheap and good. It's actually good and it's free. All right? How about posting? Do you want to post? Do you want to post amazing content? Download this app, RIPL. All right? I don't know how to pronounce it. Okay? I think it's RIP. It's an amazing app that you can do to manage content. Manage your partnership, that's the third one. Manage the crowd, manage the network, manage the tribe. A lot of us have a lot of contacts, we are everywhere. You need to collate them together. You need to classify all your people into the following groups. How many of them are your mentors, your coach, your peers, your advocates, your friends, your followers, your passerby, your followers, your stalker, plus your enemies? All of them are included. I hope you have only one or two enemies. Because if you have 10 to 20 enemies, you're in trouble. Your enemies are very interested in you. I'm very, very sure. They are the number one stalker. But you know what? You need to manage all these people, and you need to be able to tag them accordingly so that when you call out these people, you know who to connect. Your tribe is the most important asset in your personal branding. Do you want to connect with customers easily with video today? You can try Boom Boom. Yeah, Bomb Bomb actually. Bomb Bomb is very interesting. You can do any video. And sometimes you go to the landing page. This is to create a landing page. It immediately connect, immediately have lead generation, and immediately build your database. So if you're in some form of marketing, every one of us here is a marketer. You are a marketer first, then a dentist. You're a marketer first, then a speaker. You're a marketer first, then a lawyer. Why do I say that? 80% of the business is about marketing. But why are we not doing great marketing? It's because we don't understand branding. So Pia, I'm just selling your book for you. All right, yeah. And after that, after you buy his book, please look for my book, okay? All right. Number four. You've got to master this art of managing publicity. Managing mainstream publicity. I know a lot of you heard, oh, mainstream is so old school. You know, why do we mainstream? Let me tell you something. Traditional PR give you the authority. Social media PR only give you authenticity. Why do I say that? Now, which you would like to hear? You know, oh, Barik, if I tell you, you know, Barik, I saw you on Channel News Asia. You look great, man. Will you be happy? Of course you'll be happy, right? But Barik, if I tell you, you know, Barik, I saw a hidden video about you on YouTube. You will be very, very frightened. Which one do you want to be on? The authority still lies in the mainstream media, because whenever you have a big news, when the news didn't broadcast, it is not confirmed yet. Until today, it is still true. Until today, mainstream media still has the publicity. But it's the art of creating stories. So I want to share to you this. This was a story, Mother's Day, 2 years ago. Now, is it common for women to go for Botox? Okay, please don't raise your hand. There's nothing special about women looking good. But I know the press would like to cover a story of a 72-year-old woman wanting to look like 27-year-old. I asked my mom to go for it, and I got a nice write-up on a Mother's Day present. All right. You know what? The doctor was very happy. She got free publicity. Right? Okay? So, there's always the art of managing publicity. You've got to understand that, all right? And this list is a list. If you need a big picture, this is the one. This is a list of all the PR sites in the world. You can submit your press release. Okay? Quickly download Evernote, all right? And this is the local one. Yeah, Judy, where are you, Judy? Yeah, Judy, we're very happy. Judy for SPH. All right, so go to her. Okay, so this is a list. I think it's still valid. And don't forget, online publicity is about SEO backlink. SEO, on-page SEO, is only telling Google who you are. Off-page or off-site SEO tells Google how credible you are. The more backlinks you have, the better. Make sure that a very famous blogger talk about you and link back to your site. Make sure you submit your site to credible sites so that it can link back to your own brand. Your own company brand. It's very important. Number five, we have to all learn to be an author. There's nothing great today to be an author. All of us can have e-books, and all of us don't have to be a traditional book writer. There's so many options today for you, right? You can type 10,000 words and have a book on Amazon, on Kindle, on Audible. You know, last month, I gave my set of books, 3 books, 1.5 kilo, to my niece. to reward her for doing well in PSLE. She's a very good reader. I think she's the top in school for essay writing. And she looked at my book, "Uncle, got soft copy or not?" And then I realized today, books become a PR item. You look at a lot of bookstores today, all right, it's a ghost town. Really, all right. So every industry is being challenged. Today, we have to be an author, but we had to do it differently, digitize it. Next one, I'm coming to the end, public speaking. There are so many things you can join. Your stories, let me tell you a story. If yesterday there was only me, ME, yesterday, ME is me. Now with disruption today, I am MESS, I'm a mess. Whether it's a good mess or a bad mess, you are still a mess. But in the future, you become MESSAGE, message. You will form a story why a lot of things has happened to you and it's worthwhile writing. Hopefully, in the very far future, you become the messenger. So, first, there was me. Today, I'm a mess. Tomorrow, there's a message. In the future, I become a messenger. And that is the journey of book writing and public speaking. There are so many, from amateur ones. All right, Pachak Kucha is very interesting. 20 slides, 20 seconds, you cannot control. 6 minutes, 40 seconds, you're finished. All right, Tech Talk, 18 minutes. Toastmasters, prepare speech. If you want to go at the pro level, Asia Professional Speaker Singapore. All right? Yeah. By the time you go to Asia Professional Singapore, you find that there's nothing Asia about it. Because down there, it's like a global UN. Everyone is inside, all right? But when you go to the Western world, you don't find a single Chinese or an Asian. That is why I love to go to international stage. For all my international Western friends, I love you. But I love to thrive in your stage because a lot of you have thrived in my stage. Okay, so that's just personal. Erase that if you're doing video, okay? All right, so number 7, charity. You can't be a brand if your heart is only on the business. You have to serve people. What is the use of being successful in all that you do? You have to have a heart for people. You have to serve charity. Be on the board. Donate your money. Do something. And there's so much about charity today that you can set up. You can set up your own charity. You can give through electronic way. There are so many things to digitize. And it is incredible. It is so incredible that today, do you know the church many years ago was hiding 10% of your earning you give to the church? You know what? A lot of organizations are copying that because it works. The key to unlock abundance is to sacrifice the top 10% of everything you have. During the old days, the farmer had to sacrifice the best 10% of the harvest. You know, for farmers to take the best 10% of the seeds and burn it away, it's a waste because that is used to plant the next batch of crops. That shows that sacrifice temporarily unlocks abundance in the future. The last P I want to share to you is this. You have to determine your own price. If you're in business today, you don't have a boss to give you a pat on the back. Well done. You have to find your own recognition. There are so many ways to be recognized. This is the global one. And of course, this is the local one, all right? So there are a lot of personal brands that are going to be acknowledged tonight. So if you're a winner tonight and you're receiving an award, can I just invite you to stand where you are? Yeah, okay. They are too shy to stand. So next time, if I say stand, you must stand, because it's personal brand, okay? So anyway, let's give that a round of applause. If you would like to have an assessment of your personal brand, for the form against the 8P that I talk about, scan the QR code. Don't take a picture. Please take action. Don't take picture. Take action. Scan this code. Take that test. I won't spam you. I will submit a report to your email. And last but not least, please call Andrew. *263739. You will get me. Don't call me. Just send me an email. I'd love to connect. Thanks for being here. And have a great day.
Thank you, Andrew Chow, for his very exciting personal branding advice.